let's think about how we would have accounted for things. If instead of renting our building for $200,000, instead we bought the building for $2 million, how would that have shown up from an accounting profit point of view and an economic profit point of view? So we're going to buy our building for $2 million. So that is the market value of our building at the beginning of our period, at the beginning of year one. And let's say at the end of year one, so this is year one right over here that occurs, and maybe to a large degree this is because I used the building, there was a lot of traffic in there, maybe it was a brand new building before, and now it's essentially kind of, the building itself has taken some wear and tear. And because of that, the market value of the building is now $1.9 million. So essentially, through this year, the building's value has depreciated by $100,000. So we'll say the depreciation is $100,000. Notice, I didn't pay anyone that $100,000. It was not an explicit opportunity cost. But this really is an opportunity cost because I've spent this $100,000 is the opportunity cost of not selling the building a year ago. And instead using that building, I've essentially lost out on $100,000. Now that's not all that I have lost out on. I have also lost out on the ability to invest this $2 million in other things. Maybe I could have invested the $2 million at a 5% rate and gotten some interest on it. So I also have the opportunity cost of capital, of not investing that $2 million someplace else. And so the opportunity cost of capital, let's say I could have gotten 5% on my $2 million. So 5% of $2 million is $100,000. So my opportunity cost of capital right over is $100,000. Another way to think about it is, let's just say that I buy the building and I sell it at the end of the year. Then I would have literally lost $100,000 on that transaction. And although I might have used it, so I got some value out of it, and I would have lost another $100,000 by not having that money invested in some other use during that period. So these are the two non-explicit costs that will come that would show up in our profit statements. Now, this depreciation is something that is accounted for by accountants. When you look at a company's financials, you will see something called depreciation, which is a measure of how are you, you're kind of using up your capital goods. You are using up your building. You are using up your equipment. You are using up your vehicles or whatever else you might have. Economists are very pure about depreciation. They say, what was the market value at the beginning of the period? What is the market value at the end? And so the difference is how much it has depreciated. And this is kind of, it's actually almost a more natural way. In accounting, and I won't go into the details, there are many ways to depreciate something. You might be able to say, well, if the thing is worth $2 million, and if it's going to last me 10 years, I can depreciate $100,000 a year, or actually $200,000 a year, $2 million divided by 10 years. And there's different incentives based on if you are the owner of a firm of how you depreciate. You might want to actually have a lot of depreciation for tax purposes so that you can somehow hide a profit or whatever. But for the sake of this video, we're going to assume that both the accountants and the economists will mark off $100,000 of depreciation if we were to buy the building. So let's redo our two financial statements, the accounting version and the economic version. So in the accounting version, so let me copy and paste all of this. So copy, and let me go down here and paste it. Let me paste it. And so now we don't have any rent expense. Instead of renting the building, we've gone off and we've bought the building. So let me get rid of that. So our rent expense is now going to be zero. But we do have a depreciation expense, and I'll write that in another color. We do have a depreciation expense of $100,000. And we don't think about the opportunity cost of capital. What we could have done with that $2 million that we used to buy the building. And so our pre-tax accounting profit from an accounting point of view, is going to be, let's see, 50 minus 200 is 300, minus another, let me make sure I get this right. So I have I have, actually, it's gotten better because my rent was 200 and now I only have a depreciation of 100. So it's 50 minus 350 gives me a pre-tax profit of $150,000. Now let's, and that was because I was renting it for more, and now my depreciation, based on how what happened with the market rate, actually changed less than what my rent would have been. But the economic profit, at least based on the way we've done the numbers here, it'll actually come out neutral, which it should, because we're really economic profit. We're just trying to decide, does it make sense for us to run this business in this way? And so when we look at the economic profit, let's copy and paste this again. So we're gonna, let me copy just this part. So copy and paste. And maybe if things actually did improve when we actually changed whether we owned or rent, then that would say, well, that's the more economic way to do it. So let's say this year one again, but now we're doing, this is economic profit, year one. So our food is the same, our labor is the same, our rent disappears. Let me get rid of that. Let me get rid of the rent. The rent is now going to be zero. We now own our building. Rent is zero. These are all our explicit costs. These are direct outlay. These are direct payments of money to someone else. But now let's think about our implicit costs. Implicit costs. Well, we still have the same implicit costs that we had up here. We have the wages for gone. We talked about maybe I was a doctor and I'm not working as a doctor to run this restaurant. So my wages for gone are $150,000. Wages for gone are $150,000. Wages lost are $150,000. And now we have the depreciation on top of that. I'll do this in magenta to show what is new. We have the depreciation of $100,000. And on top of that, we have the opportunity cost of capital, the return we could have gotten on that $2 million that instead we used to buy the building. So I'll call it OCC. Opportunity cost of capital in this situation was the 5% of $2 million, another $100,000. So the way that I've worked out the numbers here, we didn't have to spend $200,000 on rent, but we increased our implicit costs by owning the building by $200,000. So it all comes out the same. We still get what we got in the previous one of an economic profit of negative $100,000. Negative $100,000 of economic profit. And this, of course, was accounting profit. And so what I wanted to really just highlight in this is that you don't get kind of a freebie on the economic profit when you decide to buy instead of rent, or rent versus buy. There are still ways of accounting for essentially the opportunity cost of doing any of these actions.